Hey YouTube, AppleX142 here, and in this video I'm going to be showing you how you can jailbreak your iPhone, iPod Touch or iPad running iOS 11.0 to 11.1.2 using Electra. Now this is kind of a partial jailbreak because it doesn't actually include Cydia, since Cydia hasn't yet been updated for iOS 11, but once it has been updated for iOS 11 you'll be better off using something like LibreiOS, which I'll include my guide for that one down below in the video description. But since it's not out yet, this is going to be the closest thing, and what you're going to get with this is just basically some standard stuff. You're going to get Anemone, which is an app that you use for putting themes on your device. You've probably used it if you've jailbroken your device in the last couple of years. And you also get Cydia Substrate, so you can actually install tweaks, although you have to do it manually by manually moving files into the right location. And you can find lots of guides on how to do that. The same for themes, you also have to install those manually, since there is no way of installing via a deb file that like Cydia does. So it's very, very simple. It is still a sort of semi-untethered jailbreak, so you will have to sort of rerun the jailbreak every time you reboot your device, as standard with the last few jailbreaks. That's all nothing new, and that's just something you need to bear in mind, but I'll talk about that in a little bit. But yeah, let's just get started. And what you're going to need for this method, you're going to need a computer. It can be a Mac, Windows, or Linux computer. It doesn't matter. And then basically what you're going to want to do is go to the link in the video description, which will bring you to my website here, where you can find a full written guide as well as notes on how to do this. Is it compatible with all iOS 11 devices that can run these iOS versions? So just bear that in mind. It will not work on anything above 11.1.2 though, so just bear that in mind as well. If you are above that version, unfortunately, you can't use this method. And there is no way to downgrade at the moment, so that's just something to bear in mind. But once you're here, you're going to need to get two things. You're going to need to get the IPA file for Electra, which you can get by clicking there and coming to this website here. Just click the download button at the top here to download the latest version, although if for some reason you want an older one, you can find the download links further down the page there as well. And then you can also need to download Cydia Impactor for Windows, Mac or Linux. These links will get the latest version that is available. I've already got it on my computer, but as you can see here, you would normally just unzip the zip file or DMG file that you get, depending on which OS you're using, and then just run the application or the .exe file. And it's pretty simple from here. All you have to do is get your IPA file, which I can see I've got here, and you're also going to need Cydia Impactor, which is, as you can see, I've also got it open here, and I've got my iPhone 6 Plus plugged in here. If I go to the settings application and just go down to general, about, and you can actually see it is running iOS 11.1.2, so we are on a compatible version. And as you can see, there's nothing on a home screen. This is a freshly restored device, so it's completely fresh. And as you can see, we've got the device listed in Cydia Impactor here. If you have multiple devices plugged into your computer at the same time as you're doing this, just make sure you select the right one in this drop-down menu. And then basically what you're going to want to do from here is just drag this IPA file on top of the Cydia Impactor window. At this point, you're going to need to log in with your Apple ID, so you can use your actual one or you can create another one just for this. It doesn't go anywhere except Apple server, so it's completely safe. Although if you have two-factor authentication enabled on your device, or on your account rather, you'll either need to turn it off or get an app-specific password in order for this to work, otherwise you will get an error. So just bear that in mind as well. For the most part, it's easier to just make another account. But I'm going to log in with a spare account I've made here quickly, and then as you'll be able to see, go ahead and install the application using the certificate it's going to generate. So any Apple ID, click OK and then do the password. Click OK again, and as you can see, it will now begin installing the application on our device. If you get any errors at this stage that say something about you needing to revoke certificates or you've already got certificates, what you need to do is basically just click on the little Xcode tab up here, then click on revoke certificates. It'll ask you to log in with your Apple ID again, and it should revoke anything you may already have on your device, and then just try and install it again and it should go through perfectly fine. But as you can see, after doing that, we now have the Electra application on our device. When you try and open it up straight away, you don't actually need the computer anymore at this point for this part of the tutorial. But as you can see, when you try and open it up, you're going to get a notification saying untrusted developer. So to fix that, just go to the settings application, go to general, scroll down to device management and profiles and device management, click on your Apple ID that you used, tap on trust again, and then you should be able to open up the application like normal. And as you can see, this is what it looks like. It's very, very similar to all the other jailbreak apps that have come out in the past couple of years. But just leave everything as it is, leave this toggle on here, and then tap on the jailbreak button, and it will basically just go through the process of jailbreaking, installing Anemone and Cydia Substrate and all the other things that you may need for it. And then you should be good to go. You should be able to start installing tweaks and themes manually if you know how. So it's very, very simple. Just be patient. If it doesn't work the first time when you come back on and you don't see any extra applications, just run it again. It's not 100% foolproof, so it does fail sometimes. But as you can see, it'll eventually respring your device like this, and when you come back up, you should have jailbreak applications on your home screen. Now, what I said before as well is when you reboot your device, you are going to need to actually redo that, so just bear that in mind, and I'll talk a bit more about that in a little minute. But as you can see, we now have the Anemone app on here, so you can actually go in here and enable themes if you really want to, and you can do tweaks through Filzer if you get that on your device as well. As you can see, if we go into the Electra app, you can see it already says already jailbroken. But like I was saying, whenever you reboot your device, you're going to come back up and none of your jailbreak stuff is going to work. Your themes will be disabled and all that sort of thing. That's nothing to worry about. That's very normal. All you need to do is go back into the Electra application. It'll say jailbreak again or re-jailbreak or something like that. Tap it again, it'll respring your device, and you should have all of that functionality back. The other thing to bear in mind with this application is only going to work for 7 days if you have a free Apple ID, i.e. if you didn't pay for a developer certificate to use. If you did pay for one, you'll be able to use it for a year without any problem, so I wouldn't worry about it. But as you can see, after 7 days, this is going to just basically stop working. You won't be able to open it up anymore. What that means, all you have to do is just reinstall it using the exact same method you did before, and then you'll have another 7 days to go ahead and do it. There are ways around this, so you can either get it through an online certificate where you just download it without a computer, but those versions don't get you the latest version of the jailbreak, and they often get outdated and not updated, so it's best to stay away from those if you can. Or you can use something like Cydia Extender in Cydia if you know how to do it, and it can sort of re-sign itself manually. But as you can see, that is pretty much it, all you have to do for this. Like I said, you can't get Cydia at this point, unfortunately. Hopefully that'll be coming very, very soon, so stay tuned and subscribe for a video on that soon, hopefully. But yeah, that is pretty much all you need. Like I said, everything you need will be linked in the video description below, so just check out all the links down there and read the guide there if you need to as well. But yeah, that's it. Like the video if you liked it, leave a comment if you have any questions, and as always, don't forget to subscribe.